Good morning. This is Principal Swank. We have to rewrite that school song. Just wanted to welcome you students to a new year here at William Howard Taft. Let's all hope for new beginnings and try not to do anything that would upset me. I mean it now. Let's really try. By the way, is anyone missing a goat?
Choosing a play is a very delicate process. Sometimes you have If I have a couch and a desk, I look for a place with a couch and a desk. And this year, boys and girls, we're doing, are you ready?
All covered in used pimples.
So that's where you get them from, a goose.
This year, we're doing Shakespeare.
Oh boy.
Shakespeare?
Who? Billy Bob Shakespeare, country western singer. And I want you two to audition this afternoon.
We're here.
Are we going to one of your platforms?
I got time.
Are you going to audition, Carla?
I might.
I guess I might too.
Mom, that would be nice.
Carla, why don't you just get a puppy?
Oh, shut up.
That's right, we're doing Richard III. So line up and sign in. And I need lots of men.
I'll be here.
We get to wear cool costumes.
But wasn't Shakespeare alive, like, back sometime in the 16th century or something?
He probably did by now.
We're updating the play.
So what, when? Someone who research and is there with all of the facts.
Huh?
Where will we find ourselves such a candidate?
Part to read.
Now is the
my driver's test. Shifting was the hardest part.
I can't have a character doing Shakespeare with a basketball.
I'll give you $14
faster. Now we'll give you Clarence.
I'll give you $15 if you don't.
Missus, we can have Clarence coach a team or something.
I want to read from Margaret Dorsey.
That's the Mark Theodore set, and it's a guy.
I think I'll stick around a while and watch.
Nuh-uh, you're just game to see that I don't run off.
You're in the show. Live with it.
I'll read Richard, Duke of York, and later, King Richard III.
Someone to read Lady Anne?
I'll read Lady Anne.
Fine, we'll start the game right here.
Still trying to upstage me, huh?
I'm trying to help you.
Help me by running against me for president?
I didn't say I'm gonna run.
Smart.
Oh, do you think I'm just trying to help you but nothing else?
What?
Is that it? Anytime you're ready.
Lady, you know no rules of charity.
Don't talk to me about charity. I try to get you to listen.
That's the line.
Go on.
Which renders good for bad, blessings for curses.
Villain, thou knowest the law of thine own hand. Thou be so fierce, but knowest the touch of pity.
But I know none, and therefore am no beast.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful when a devil tells the truth.
Don't listen to him.
More wonderful when angels are so angry.
Angels, he says.
Watch him, girl.
He's trying to get around you now.
Vouchsafe to find perfection of a woman, of these supposed evils to give me leave. By circumstance, but to equip myself, huh?
Yourself, you know what's best.
You shut up.
I never saw students get into Shakespeare this much before.
Vouchsafe, diffuse infection of a man. For these no evil, but to give me leave by circumstance. To curse, I curse self.
Yeah!
Go, girl.
Fairer than tongue can name thee, let me have some patient leisure to excuse myself.
Well, excuse you.
Foul in the heart to thank thee. Thou canst make no excuse for it, but to hang thyself. You want to know something else? I am running for president.
Yes!
Oh,
yes. No!
Please, I fear me.
I'll get a notice on the paper.
You were all in my house. What did you say to her?
Oh! Like a traitor!
What's going on?
Him, that's what. Did you see this?
Yeah. Bridget has my vote. Jason!
Oh please. Let me vote for Bridget. If I vote for Carl, will never like me.
Jay, you can vote for whoever you want.
Dad!
Well, I want to win, sure, but I don't want a strong arm in place.
Right. Armstrong?
Oh, I'm serious. Look, we're going to win, but we're going to win fair and square. Right? Right?
Sure.
Alright, now I'll show you how we're going to pull this. I got Wayne working on the plane.
Brain? Wayne, brain?
Good morning, gentlemen. Now, if I may have your undivided attention, I believe I have here a schematic for an assault on the collective student psyche that will grasp and hold their political clout and turn the tide, as it were, into a unanimous triumph for Tad.
God, Kennedy.
Oh, listen, he's taking over as campaign manager, and I think
Hold it.
All right. Look, Jason, it's up to you who you vote for. But if you're on Bridget's side, you can't be here.
I'll be good.
Get
going. Are you sure your henchmen are capable of implementing our rather complicated overtures?
If you use small words.
He really has a bad throat.
Yeah,
he
got
out
of town or something.
Now, if you three will accommodate yourselves satisfactorily, I will begin my dissertation. Yeah. Oh. You sit, me talk. Now, what we have orchestrated, here's the scoop. We're going to work on a word of mouth campaign. Each of us will talk to everyone we see, really laud all of Tad's virtues. Put in a good word for him.
Sure thing.
Go. Then, when Thaddeus gives his speech, he'll outline everything we've already told them.
Only don't tell him anything specific. No, just the usual. I've been president, I know the ropes, that sort of thing.
No problem. Maybe we should list some of the things.
Like what?
Well, like making sure students have more of a voice in planning long-range activities, handing out weekly newsletters, finding all those for
school. Where are you getting all this?
These flyers for all the Virginia girls hanging out.
They're running up flyers?
And bumper stickers and balloons.
Flyers, bumper stickers, and balloons.
Say, that thing about the students having more of a voice sounds really good. What, I got something stuck to my face again?
Yeah, you're gonna have this stuck to your face in a few minutes.
Your opponent seems to be a few moves ahead of you already, sir.
Can't believe she's doing this to me.
Tad, we can't let them get away with this.
Oh, okay, Tad, I have your costume here. Let's try some things on. We'll see what we can use. Here you go. See if this fits.
So with this cape.
It has a hump built into it. Richard III was deformed. He had a hump.
I knew that.
Well, let's see what we have here.
I'm wearing a wig.
Part of the character.
We need to come up with something.
And something really underhanded.
Well, maybe we can utilize some of our more convincing political ploys. Dirty tricks!
Oh. I told you, we're not doing anything like that.
You do watch the wave, right?
This is Clovis. We have 5 minutes.
We need to get some photos for the top telegraph.
School newspaper? Great. Some advanced publicity for the show.
What are you doing?
Let me get a picture of Richard.
Oh, this will be just fine.
Now, lean forward, hunch over, and scowl.
Scowl?
Make a menacing face. Show the cruelty of the character.
Gotcha.
How's that?
And one more for insurance.
Great, that's just what we need.
Let me show the picture. Bridget made from the movie.
Wonderful. And what kind of dirty tricks? You didn't hear that.
Dad, I can't take sides.
You can if you want to bridge the third.
That kind!
I am determined to prove a villain and hate the idle pleasures of these days. Thoughts have I laid, inductions dangerous by prophecies, libels, and dreams. I am subtle, false, and treacherous. Dive thoughts down to my soul. Here Clarence comes. But here Clarence comes.
My Majesty has appointed this hobbit to convey me to the tower. Who talks like this?
Try without the basketball?
Hey, if I start doing things without my basketball, my mom will take it away from me.
You make it sound like you sleep with that thing.
That's so sad.
Miss Clovis?
Yes?
Oh my goodness!
How's this look?
Jason?
Is that you in there?
Yeah, I'm playing around the walking camp. What does it look like?
Like you're going to ask the wizard for a heart.
My bodyguard.
In the play or during the election?
How about during the vote? That was a joke.
I see.
Look, I didn't start any of this.
No, but you can stop it.
Not a quitter.
You just don't get it, do you? A person is judged not on what they promise, but on what they deliver. Not on what they say about others, but who they themselves are. Character is what you make of yourself. Reputation is what others receive from you. And above all, thine own self be true. And your help is coming undone.
Fight fire with fire, that's what I always say. And I've been involved in many fires, let me tell you.
What do you think about that town?
Did you see the newspaper?
This is really rank.
What?
I was trying to make a point here.
Sorry.
Losers!
You look like an action figure.
Shut up.
I'm like a still.
How do you know what a still looks like?
That would
be. Hey, it burned up. Put the fire out. Now can we please all move on now?
This is horrible. They call me pompous, rude, uncaring, egotistical, and vain.
Wait till you read the bad stuff. This is really getting out of hand.
Mrs. Clovis, have I seen this?
We're reading the reviews now.
How can you let this happen?
Me? What do I have to do with it?
You were the moderator?
I was? When did that happen?
Principal Clovis, what did you do? Wait, you weren't at the meeting, were you?
Did Principal Slunk decide that?
How would I know? I've never seen the woman. As far as I can tell, she's just a voiceover speaker. Never met the woman.
Never mind.
Yeah.
believe everything you wrote here.
I didn't write that.
Hey, watch that thing, will ya?
Sorry.
You don't believe me after all we've been through?
Therefore, we need to make a difference in this debate. But how do you find out what the girls are playing with?
She's right. We need to find out their plan.
Hiya. Say, maybe there's something in this play with you. Mrs. Clovis is always talking about how to blow a backstab in the
In Shakespeare? You don't seriously think we can learn anything from Shakespeare, do you?
Yeah, I guess you're right. I mean, these people are running around, wearing tights, speaking in some foreign language.
Yeah, English!
You know, what was Clovis doing? When they did these plays for the first time, the guys dressed up as little ladies. Can you believe it? Dressing up as girls. What a dumb idea.
Is it? Is it really a bad idea?
Oh, me and my big mouth. I'm not going to do it.
It's a great idea. We'll both do it.
Oh, sir.
Tucker, we always said we take that from our mothers.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Principal Slong speaking yet again. I know how much you look forward to my little announcements. Let's see here. Well, first, who parked in my spot? Please move your car. And second, don't, I repeat, do not send anyone taking driver's training to move it. We all remember what happened last time. That was a very old tree, too. Also, I'm gratified to see everyone taking such an interest in the upcoming elections. I'm also glad I'll be out of town all week. And lastly, to whoever put the sign on my back that says, kick me, I'll find you.
You couldn't have picked a better time to drop by. We're right in the middle of our elections, and there's a real tight race going on with the president. They know that. That's why they came by.
Hey, they vote
over here.
They don't vote over here.
Say, do you go back then?
I don't go to school here. Use
your head.
Right, you just know the ways to make sure
you're
sure. Yeah.
How? They can't count. Come on, girl. You gotta go find Carla.
See what else she's got planned for the debate. See you girls later.
Well, he already has it.
Yeah.
Ew. And you did that without dribbling. I've been practicing. Who do you have dates with?
Two very handsome boys.
Yes, Farrell and Tucker.
Those idiots! No, great guys, friends of ours. Say, we're just wondering if you're gonna vote this Friday.
Yeah, who for? Shoot, I thought I had at least two.
Who are you gonna vote for?
Who do you want us to vote for?
Well, I don't want to try and tell you what to do, but I know two ladies as lovely as you!
Anymore.
I'm not going to teach your boat, are you?
I don't know, I just don't know.
He ran in here! Bullfighter!
Shakespeare. I'm a teacher. I can barely support myself.
I'll sleep in your garage. I'll be your slave.
Why do kids always meet here?
Look, after the debate, Jason may not be the only one you need to worry about.
Yeah, just wait till some of the other boys hear what we're going to do once we're in office.
Oh no.
Ain't no guy who's refreshed on this one. Ain't no guy who's depend on who that is.
I haven't made up my mind yet.
We can't go.
This is Principal Slunk. I'm back. Just wanted to mention that the debate for student council president is today. I know because someone pasted "get out, vote" all over my car. I applaud your zeal, your enthusiasm, and I've also contacted those parents whom I felt should know about your zeal and enthusiasm. Try to have a nice day, because when you get home,
we need to set up for the debate.
Should I just go down here?
Yes, we need two chairs in each podium.
It should be up to the students to decide.
What could be so wrong about that?
Well, we didn't plan for that.
Exactly. Vice principal?
Well, I don't see how it could do any harm. I'm not saying it can't do any harm. I just haven't figured out how yet. Bridget?
I agree. Well, it makes sense.
Any questions for the two candidates?
Hey!
What?
I'm the moderator.
Sorry.
Now, any questions for the two candidates? Come on, let's not drag this out.
He said, any questions?
I do, Mr. Armstrong.
Yes?
Do you ever feel in a present turmoil of existence, in light of world events, keeping in mind our own views on political correctness, that your experience will serve the student body to its fullest extent?
I believe that experience is the best teacher.
You think so, don't you?
Mr. Kilroy!
I'll be quiet. Any other questions?
Ted, do you believe in term limits?
I don't believe this.
I believe that anyone who can continue to get the job done and meet the approval of his constituents should be able to keep the job.
Thank you. That's who I'm voting for.
Objection! They're leading the witness.
Huh?
They're doing something.
Will you sit down?
Bridget?
Yes?
Do you support progress in changing the direction of the student body if it seems to be stagnating?
What?
I heard something like that on Meet the Press.
I believe that if changes are needed, it's up to the president to introduce these changes and be a leader. However, it's up to the students to vote on any changes that will involve them as a whole.
All right. Miss Brown, do you feel that sensationalism and mustering have no place in these elections?
I do.
Good answer.
Now, does anyone else have any planted questions for these candidates?
Cheerleaders can vote, right? Of course.
Also, we can vote.
If we could just move on to closing speeches, I can try to regain my sanity. And I think Pat should go first because Bridget went first in the
opening. Mr. Moderator.
What is it now?
I thought that since we have the whole student body present, I might mention our upcoming drama production.
Fine, but make it quick. I got a roast in the oven.
Now, as many of you know, we're doing Bridget the Third for our first production. Well, many of you may wonder why we bother doing Shakespeare these days. The writing is hard to understand, and these people lived centuries ago. However, there are many similarities in these plays to today's events and issues. Richard III was a rather despicable character who did everything he could to become the King of England. In other words, he used a lot of tricks to achieve his goals, a lot of dirty tricks. And those who worked for him did the same. They acted as agents, but he was the one who took responsibility for it all. He resorted to all sorts of tricks and schemes. He only cared about himself, didn't care about his people or his country, and only wanted the position for himself. Plus, there's all sorts of bloody battles and swordplay, and I'm sure you'll all have a great time watching this. So I expect to see you all opening night, okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Clovis. I still think we should have caps, but... Now, as I was saying, I believe it's time for the closing speeches. And I think Pat should go first because Bridget went first in the opening.
Mr. Kilroy?
Oh, what is it now?
With Tad's permission, I would like to go first.
Wait!
Wait!
Come on. I'll be quiet.
I'll allow it.
Thank you. Whenever we are called upon to elect an official or representative, we must take the matter to heart. We must be allowed to judge the candidate's value, weigh his credentials and aspirations. We should never be swayed by any campaign gimmicks or by unsupported claims.
And you let her go first.
Shut up, she's making a lot of sense.
Above all, we should use our vote to work for good, to keep and maintain our democratic society. It is a cherished tradition in this great country of ours and not one to be taken lightly. And if any candidates show themselves not worthy of our trust, we should also seek out the truth. For the truth is all that matters in any election. We vote not for a candidate, but for our ideals, for what we believe is right.
Me.
It's all going so wrong.